Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to St. Peter's. We're going to go old school for the first song tonight, please. So if you would pick up your missalettes, or your hymnals, and turn to the hymn number 634, This Day God Gives Me, number 634. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come no further, and here shall your proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who might live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was, and other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A violent gust of wind came up and waves were breaking over the boat. "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." Lord, we got trouble. Right here in River City, right here in the Gym City. Don't worry, I'm not going to break into song. I'll leave that to Anne. But the fact is, today's gospel passage, at least in my estimation, presents us with quite a bit of trouble. The gospel seems to always be chock full of trouble, from stonings to storm clouds. Trouble is present at every turn throughout sacred scripture. Today's trouble takes us for a boat ride on the Sea of Galilee, and who doesn't love a boat ride? The only problem is that today's weather is not boat ride weather. And yet, here we are in the boat with the trouble. The events of today's gospel passage take place after Jesus has been preaching parables of lampstands and mustard seeds. He has just admonished his faithful flock to follow him, and yet this ragtag group of disciples immediately defies this action by instead trying to lead him into the boat. Jesus does not need to be led. He is God. He needs only to be followed. As the celestial sun sets, the Son of God settles in for the ride. Exhausted from preaching to the masses, Jesus curls up and settles in for a nap. Jesus is quite literally asleep at the wheel. As evening draws close, as the winds gust, as the waters rage, as the storm sets in, the sea, reminiscent of poor Jonah, is literally swallowing them alive, and the great Messiah, the great Savior, is asleep at the wheel. What are the disciples to do? Here we are, in the boat with the trouble. I think we often feel that way too. If we're honest with ourselves, we often feel that Jesus is asleep at our proverbial wheel too. In the midst of our suffering and pain, grief and sorrow, woe and distress, moving to a new parish, we often feel disconnected, cut off from Jesus's undying love, mercy, compassion, presence. And we get confused. We begin to ask questions like, "If you love me, why can't I feel your presence? If you desire me to be happy, why have you allowed this to happen to me? If you are all powerful, why can't you take this pain away from me?" And the list goes on and on. As the questions plague us, we begin to feel both increasingly detached from Jesus and yet, paradoxically, increasingly in need of Him. Our grief blows us over like a crushing wind. Our anxiety rises and thrashes us like waves hitting our boats. And like the disciples, we cry out to Jesus, "Do you not care that we are perishing? Do you not care that we are perishing?" Here we are in the boat with the trouble. So how do we understand this? How do we understand that Jesus sometimes seems to be asleep when we are most in need of Him? The answer, in some ways, is quite simple. Jesus is never asleep. Jesus is never out of touch with us. Jesus is never separated from us. He is always awake. He is always in touch with us. He is always with us, and He is always ready to intercede for us. Our task, like the disciples in today's gospel, is to have the faith to know that this is true. And that's not easy sometimes, but that's also not new. Just think about what we know of Jesus's early followers. They denied Him, sold Him out, doubted His presence, rebuked Him, reviled Him, refused to believe Him, tested Him, preferred silver to Him, and the list goes on and on. And that, brothers and sisters, is good news. Despite their clear flaws, transgressions, disbelief, Jesus still chose them. He still calmed the storm that was about to swallow them up. A violent gust of wind came up and waves were breaking over the boat. "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." After crying out to Jesus, He woke up, commanded the winds to cease and the sea to calm. By this action, He showed that He is one with the Father, one with the Creator, and as such has power and dominion and love over creation. Through the great gift of His Son, He comes to dwell among us, to dwell among His creation. Out of His great love for His creation, He brings peace and stillness to an otherwise chaotic, wave-stricken world. He does it for the disciples in our little gospel story today, and He wants to do it for you and I too. The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then He asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" You see, brothers and sisters, the scene from today's gospel story is a clear snapshot that plays out in our lives time and time again. When the storm winds are blowing, we often feel cut off from faith. When the waves are crashing up against our boat, we often feel disconnected from Christ. But today, Jesus is showing you and I that even in the midst of the raging winds and waves of our own lives, Jesus is still the captain of our boats. Jesus is still in charge, lovingly guiding us, lovingly protecting us, lovingly interceding for us. Jesus is with us in the boat with the trouble. As life's ominous storm clouds are bringing darkness into our lives, we can choose fear or we can choose faith. As life's crushing waves begin to spill over into our boats, we can choose fear or we can choose faith. We can try to ride out the storm on our own, or we can reach out to Him for comfort, for peace, for consolation. We can cooperate with the people He puts in our lives to help us, to guide us, to show us His love. Our task is not to overlook, reduce, ignore, or sweep the problems we face under the rug. Instead, our task is to turn to Him, to the Prince of Peace, to bring us peace, strength, and courage to weather the storm. And He will do that in His own way, in His own time, Sometimes we'll see that and sometimes we won't, because he is with us in the boat with the trouble and also with the faith, with the peace, with the courage, with the love. Brothers and sisters, today, put your hand into the hand of the man who stilled the waters and cast out the storm clouds. Put your hand in the hand of the man who died for you and me so that we might have life and have it abundantly. Today, receive that very same Jesus, that very same Jesus who stilled the raging seas, made present right here in this church on this altar. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Confident in God's love for us, we place these our petitions at the seat of Christ's mercy.
For the church and her work to bring healing to those in need, may God strengthen her in her mission, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from depression or anxiety, may God bring them comfort and respite, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of this worship community, may God strengthen our faith as we face trials and hardships, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace and stability in the nation of Haiti. May the Prince of Peace be near those living in fear, and may he bless them with unending hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Auden Romilly Neiman, Thomas Cavitley, Declan Ryan, Lovett and Raven Branham, Oakland and Paisley Smith, and Lincoln Woodyard, as they receive the grace of baptism in our church this weekend and next week, that they may continue to grow closer to Christ as a child of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, including Mary Ephron, who passed away this past week, that they may know the glory and the splendor of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our special intentions, especially for the intention of this Mass, Bob and Eileen Anderson, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, in your love and in your mercy, we ask you to hear and answer these prayers if they be in accordance with your will. We ask this as we do all things through Christ, our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of all the Holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Peter and John the Baptist, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, Bob. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety,
If you pass through raging waters in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be I have one announcement for this evening. Please join us tomorrow from noon to 3 for our farewell open house for Father Zach in the cafeteria.
If you don't come, maybe that means I don't have to leave. You know, that's kind of what I'm thinking. Maybe I just won't show up. I'm kidding. Come. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the